Very good evening from the sports desk. Motjeka Madisha's family will finally lay him to rest tomorrow. The defender's family confirmed that he had indeed died in a car crash back in December. Now, our reporter Tsepo Tobane has been following the proceedings at Madisha in Limpopo, where Madisha will be buried. He is, of course, already in Limpopo, and he'll be joining us live in just a short moment as we get there. We do know, of course, that Madisha did die in Kempton Park in December, the 12th of December, and we had waited 8 weeks to confirm DNA results. So, Tsepo, a very good afternoon to you. We say good afternoon given the circumstances that we are now facing. Obviously a tragic turn of events that has brought us here to this point. How's the family been coping?
Afternoon, Morena. I mean, as you correctly said it, I mean, what a tragic event for this promising youngster. I mean, Motjeka Madisha was almost at his prime of his career. Things were looking up for him at 25, and then he passed away in that manner. But I'm here at Madisha in Zebediela, in Limpopo, where he grew up. I'm with the family members here. The final preparations are being made for his funeral service that is going to take place here at this house tomorrow morning. I mean, with me here, I've got some of the family members, that is the sister and also the family spokesperson. We'll start with the family spokesperson. I mean, afternoon, just briefly tell us about the preparations. How is everything going ahead of tomorrow's funeral?
Thank you very much, Sepo. It has been a very strenuous event, especially for the Madisha family. Ever since the 13th of December last year, it has been so difficult for the entire family, not only for the entire family, but also the community here at Madisha Lolo. So far, as a result of the contributions made by Mamelodi Sundowns management, we have now reached a closure as a family. Because now we have been preparing for the funeral arrangements, as you might all know that the great ace, Motjeka Madisha, will be buried on the 6th, that is tomorrow, starting from 7 a.m. here at Madisha Lolo.
Thank you so much, Fanny. Let's speak to one of the sisters. I mean, I'm sure you are also, despite the telling or tough circumstances, you are relieved that finally you will be able to bury your brother tomorrow morning.
Yeah, it's been a long journey. It's been difficult. It's been straining. It's been like a lot of emotional damage. And last on Thursday, when they told us that the results are finally out, we were like, oh, finally we'll be able to lay him to rest. And because we had fear that maybe it might be not him, maybe he's somewhere captive. But then when they told us it's him, we accepted, because it's very hard. He was a very bubbly person. He was fun to be around with. Like, if he came here, he made those plates so alive. He was filled with life. And we looked so forward to so many things, because he was going very far. He was a star indeed, and he was our star. And we're so hurt. We're going to miss him. Robala ka khutjo mokoni. Rest in peace, Motjeka.
Thank you so much. Maybe briefly, Fanny, just tell us about the delay. Why was the delay in terms of the DNA results? Briefly explain to us, why did it take so long for the remains to be finally confirmed?
Well, I must say that we were deeply disappointed. Remember, firstly, the trauma that the family went through, and that was coupled by the uncertainty on the part of finalizing whether it was him or it was not him. This is on the part of government, I must say. I must be open and frank in terms of how government handled the whole issue. So, as I said earlier on, that it is as a result of the contributions made by Mamelodi Sundowns that we went via the route of getting the private laboratory services that help us, because now the results that we are talking about now, it's as a result of the private lab that Mamelodi Sundowns assisted the family with. I mean, I must be honest and open and frank to say that if it was for the government, we would still be waiting now. We'd still be waiting.
Thank you so much, guys. I know it's tough times, but thank you so much for your time. Well, Morena, you've heard it. They are just relieved that finally, after almost close to 2 months, they are finally going to be burying Motjeka Madisha tomorrow.
That's Tsepo Tobane. Thank you very much, Tsepo. He'll be following proceedings tomorrow as Motjeka is being laid to rest. Robala ka khutjo, Motjeka. And that's